and I'm the only coming up, yeah. Used to have a silver tooth and I was just a pup, yeah. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pups. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. Got a shorty clean appendix, I'm a diamond in the rough. Hey.
24 karat BBs in a slug. Rings going off like Mikey with the thug. Only one mobbing with designers in the thug. When we shop Africa, gone, bring a bottle full of couple platinum records, latest still I got the game locked. Cut my lines fresher than Tory Lanez pop. Who got his swerve and is missing every raindrop? Hit him with the... The nigga, they brain swap. Walk around like I'm Negro with the diamonds in the clock. Ooh, walking on these, I got diamonds in my socks.
While much of the country is struggling under cold temps and some of that white stuff, no such troubles here at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. It is week 16 in the NFL, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Miami Dolphins. Happy Christmas Eve to all. What a good one we have in store as we are underway here in week 16. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. They really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
Have to admit, I was extremely impressed by what I saw. They ended up getting 4 sacks in the game, stayed in the face of the quarterback the entire time, made it difficult for him to step up and find receivers downfield.
And that's what they told us this week, that pressure on the QB is key. Now Prescott. That's Gallup on the slant. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a gain of 16 in the Dallas first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Prescott. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Keon Crossan. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Ben, I wonder if someone's down there checking on the head coach right now because he might be in a little bit of shock after what just transpired. Instead of a lengthy opening drive to deal with, his guy stepped up and stole that drive away. Momentum on their side now. How will they attack on offense?
Now Achane on first and 10. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
And Charles, you think about this offense, and it's kind of a tricky time of the season because you're 14-0, looking to see this one out to the end, but you start to run into situations where guys are getting a little banged up, maybe could use some time sharing, some time on the bench, just to rest. How do you approach the rest of this regular season?
I'm telling you, you don't ask the easy stuff, do you? I mean, you created a heck of a situation, and actually, you didn't create it. You presented it, and you're exactly right. It is tricky because your eye has to be the ultimate prize, which is the Super Bowl. That's paramount. But at the same time, how much fun would it be to go down as one of the all-time great teams and join the 1972 Dolphins as the only undefeated team to win a Super Bowl?
I don't know about you, Brandon, but I often think to myself, in these situations, I want a back who can create his own space, who can break tackles, and in a sense, become his own blocker. We don't have that guy in the game right now.
Going to the air, Tagovailoa. And it's intercepted at the goal line. He's got daylight. And it's a huge return as he brings this all the way back down to the 15-yard line.
Well, Brandon, as they say in popular culture, this one's going to leave a mark because they can see the end zone, but it'll stay out of reach because of their error. All their offensive teammates have to give the quarterback right now, offer a little bit of encouragement because what's done is done. Let's get them next time out.
Following the interception, here's Prescott. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
On second down, it's Pollard. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
On third down, it's Prescott. And he is caught. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. 12 yards on third down as the drive rolls on.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, you just need the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Here we go now on first and goal. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Well, they went with a fullback dive that time.
And, Brandon, when I was a kid, the fullback carried the ball equally as much as the running back, then known as the halfback. Nowadays, the fullback's job is to block. Put him out in front. Let him clear a path.
They still have a couple more chances here from the one. It's a keeper with Prescott, and he will take it in for a Cowboy score. The sneak successful from a yard out, and the Cowboys take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Aubrey good with a PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
They'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. And he's top five in the league in terms of receiving yardage because of plays like that. What have you seen from him on film that you like so much?
Well, I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth. When the ball's arriving and there's a defender there, he just comes down with the ball. He competes and takes it away. Great hands, great ability to finish the catch.
All his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted.
And the Cowboys will have solid field position here as they take over at their 45-yard line. So the interception there, and Charles, I'd imagine that's something you can maybe live with in December, but not come January.
And I love how you make the distinction there. You're talking about regular season versus the postseason, the playoffs. Because these guys, they've already clinched a playoff spot, but they know, looking ahead, when they get into the postseason, they've got to take better care of the football because turnovers in that situation, they really become magnified.
They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. You talk about this Miami defense. Well, they've been very good this year against the pass, currently holding on to a top 10 ranking at number 10.
And while teams don't like to talk about it, they're pretty proud of their rankings. But this ranking is going to be put to the test today because they're going up against a top 5 passing offense in this one.
On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Here's Prescott. They'll roll him out right. He's got his target. That's complete. And he's finally taken down. And it's a big gain there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10.
Hey, just kill. Here's on 46. Here's on kill. 46.
From the red zone now, Prescott. And this is going to be incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Here's second and 10. Pollard will take it up the gut. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard, his 12th rushing touchdown of the year. And the Cowboys have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Now the extra point up and good by Aubrey. And that'll make the score 14-0. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out.
All right, come on.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week? Not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Tua signaling to change things up. Up the middle, Achane. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now they'll shift things around. On first down, back to Achane. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Ball on the 30 now. Here's a second down and 9.
Brings up second and nine.
Tua gonna throw. That's out to Hill, right side complete. Only able to gain a couple there. Third and seven now.
A gain of two brings up third and seven.
So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. They got to get it to the 21 here on third down. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and seven. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. That ball caught. It's chosen. So this offense able to convert on fourth. And now a fresh set of downs here. First and ten. Here's Tua. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. Second and one from the two.
Second and a yard at the 2 yard line.
Looking to pass. Tua. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11 yard line. Osa Odighizawa. He's the one to get him, and that is sack number seven for him on the year. So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long. Achan gets it from the gun. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. No sign of Tua departing. Fourth down, they're going for it. Tagovailoa going for it on fourth down. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. And the Cowboys are going to get the ball back on the turnover. They hold on fourth and goal. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around a defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
First down, Prescott flushed out right, and he wisely will throw that one away. Now a second and ten. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead. Gonna run again here with Pollard. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Jalen Phillips, the edge man on the tackle.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
Now second and nine. Prescott down. Open man downfield is Lamb. It's complete. Down the left sideline. Touchdown, Cowboys! CeeDee Lamb, his 21st touchdown of the season. And the Cowboys will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
Aubrey Good with a PAT, and it's now 21 to nothing. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And Charles, you're down multiple scores, less than a minute left here, but with that deficit, they've got to try to at least work their way into field goal range to try to muster something out of this drive.
And I'm going to go ahead and date myself one more time because I'm going to quote an old Smokey and the Bandit lyric. They've got a long way to go and a short time to get there, but they still have time to get it done. So I'm looking forward to watching them mount this drive and see if they can get some points out of it.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Escaping the pressure right. Outright caught by Chosen. A big play there just before halftime. 41 yards. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
44.
This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Two and a throw again. Toward the pylon, caught. A gain of seven that time, second goal. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal?
All right, fellas, listen up.
Achan will take this in for the Dolphin touchdown. Jason Sanders now for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and that'll cut the lead to 21-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And with 8 seconds on the clock, really not a lot of time to try to put anything together. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. The Dolphins down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter.
And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now, they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
44 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry. And they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
Here now, second and four. Again, it's Achane. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Hey, come on, G. Solo left Zion.
Tua now on first down. They'll swing this out wide. Here's Achane.
And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll bring up a second and short. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Dolphins first down.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They run out of the shotgun with Mostert. And he's able to work his way down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
Meanwhile, Tua's throw caught by his receiver, Hill.
That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards.
Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 12-yard line.
Here's 2nd and 3. Now Tua.
Got his tight end. That's complete. That's Hill. Touchdown, Dolphins. First career NFL touchdown,
and the Dolphins have got it back to where they score. So they get their tight end away from the line to the outside, and he works his way in for 6.
Tight ends are not just blockers anymore. I don't know how many more times we need examples, but here's a great one. Gets to the outside, they give him the ball pretty quickly, and they trust him to get those extra yards, and boy, did he come through, pulling his way into the end zone after the nice catch.
Now to kick it away after the touchdown. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. A
about set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. But Charles, they still have the lead despite their defense giving up a touchdown on the previous possession. And even though they have that lead, it feels like a back-and-forth ball game where to try to get momentum back, maybe they need at least three here on this drive.
I think you're right about that, Brandon, because your game plan doesn't change. I do believe your urgency does because of the last score that went against your team. So what you want to do now is have your own drive and try and make sure that that momentum stays in your camp.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Gallup in motion right. Now the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. Prescott now on second down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Prescott to throw it. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. So, my goodness, I wouldn't have thought this possible not too long ago, but that turnover there means we have a game again.
Yeah, it's been a completely different team here in the second half. I just wonder on the other side of the field, where the starters telling the backups, get ready, you're going to get some playing time. And now guess what? Hope they didn't cut the tape off of their wrists and ankles. They've got to go back out there and play.
Short completion, just 4 yards, and that'll make it second down.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Second and six.
Out.
Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. He'll dump this off to Achane. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. It's his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progression, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now you got to the check down. A nice safe throw and a good one.
Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. Dancing to his left. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
I did like his decision-making there to make sure they picked up something instead of forcing a throw. Now they've got more manageable play coming up to try and pick up the first down. And don't rule out the possibility that he just keeps it and runs again.
On second down, a run by Achane. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. One quarter remains here in week 16. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the fourth. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. They'll run, Achane, and he is in! Touchdown, Miami! Devon Achane with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. Don't forget the extra point, it's up and good. One that is, as we are tied now early in this fourth quarter. this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They no longer have the lead after that last touchdown, all tied up in the fourth quarter, and a chance for this offense to mount a potential game-winning drive right here. Tackle that time by Jerome Baker out of Ohio State.
If you're a coach, you'll absolutely take that run every time on first down because it really sets you up to go in a number of directions here on second.
They go back to Pollard on second down. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. This would be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are.
Season of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Jonathan Hankins in on the stop.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Second and seven, operating from the 34. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down.
And part of a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Tua getting it quickly out to Waddle. It'll go as a gain of four, and that will bring up second down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
4 yards. Second and six at the Cowboys' 18-yard line.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. Throw caught by Achane. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. That's going to be caught by Waddle. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It goes as a gain of nine, and it moves the chains.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
You know, when this offense gets down here near the end zone, they're going to turn to their bell cow. And this guy's been a touchdown machine all year. Excellent job stopping him there on first down.
Second and goal from inside the five.
21 G.
They fake the handoff. Now Tua. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. That time, multiple defenders getting pressure, and it's a loss of six.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack, but he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
This is third and goal. Tua sets up to pass it. Tied up, less than 2 minutes to go. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They're looking at fourth and goal here in a tie ball game. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This for the lead in the final stages. Sanders' kick is good. And they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes.
So he waited on the sideline for his first chance in the ballgame, and it didn't come until the fourth quarter, but he connects there. A big one to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net. You're not really ready when you go out there. All that beef is coming at you trying to block the kick. Big spot, and he delivers.
They'll come up first and 10 here. Now Dak. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted.
And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line. It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away.
Going for the knockout punch. They'll try and run.
And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8.
Oh, Brandon, I'm going to tell you, this is football time to me. They're inside the 10-yard line. That's like drawing the line in the sand. Who's going to make the stand here? Defensive guys, they know if he gets in the end zone, this ball game is over. And the guys with the football right now, they're thinking, let's just pound it in there.
Got to hold him to 3 to keep this a 1-score game.
One more time with A-Chan.
And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. After that run, still a good amount of meat on the bone here for this third down play. Can you envision them putting this in the air?
Totally. I mean, look at who he has under center right now. If you can't trust him with the football, you can't trust anyone. And frankly, to me, I want the ball down the stretch. Get the first down, keep it in the hands of my offense. I don't want to turn it over to them and rely on my D.
Back to throw is Tua. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense. So he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Here we go, a big play and a tight game late. They're going on fourth and goal.
Let's go. What?
They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt, and the Cowboys defense is going to get them the football back.
Here's first and 10. Now Prescott.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Bradley Chubb in there to drop him as that clock continues to run.
Here's second down. Here's Prescott.
He's going to let it fly.
Oh, and that nearly ended it. That should have been intercepted, but he cannot corral it, and that is a lifeline there with third down coming up.
Oh, they took a big shot, just trying to get within sight of field goal range. But that was not to be, and now the task gets more difficult because you're looking at maybe 2 more plays here to give your kicker a chance.
To throw, Prescott.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he bats it away and it falls down incomplete.
Well, you're at the point where you had to take the shot no matter the damage.
might turn out to be irrelevant with how little time is remaining.
Gotta avoid the flags defensively. Here's fourth and long.
Desperation time. Prescott on fourth. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And now, boy, the ball's going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Fast pass outside complete. And he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play on this ball game. Well, that second half, Charles, a little bit.